any pet peeves about your home. Today I'm going to share with you three things that we did during our home renovation that are just going to make our lives a little bit easier and just eliminate those things that kind of bugged me. This is Decisions with Dani. I'm Dani Matisinko in Scottsdale, Arizona. We're doing a kitchen and a master bathroom renovation remodel, and I wanted to share with you a little bit about the process and the sheer number of decisions that need to be made. Everything is a decision, and if you are considering a remodel or maybe in the midst of it, thought you might like to follow along. Today we're going to talk about three of my pet peeves and what we did about it. One of the things that we tackled in our kitchen was maximizing the space. So a couple of things I want to say on that. I'm going to show you really quick how we maximize the space in the corner. That's a really cool thing to do if you're considering designing new cabinetry. Let me show you that. So here's my pro tip on that. When it comes to space saving, you see a lot of cool things on Pinterest. Everything looks cool. I can name 20 things that I would have done if I had a bigger kitchen, if my layout was different, if we did custom cabinetry, tip out drawers for your silverware, toe kicks with extra space. There's a million things that you can do, but I think that what the best thing to do here is think about your space, think about how you function, and pick and choose carefully. Perfect example of that is I really wanted these cool drawers inserts so I can divide up my Tupperwares, but some of these are built in and you might change your mind later about how you want to use the space. So you don't want to lock yourself down too much to built in things that you can't tweak later, but you do want to make the most of every inch. My other pro tip on that is you don't have to have everything you see on Pinterest. Pick and choose really carefully. Work with a good professional who's seen it all, done it all before, and know how these things really function. Just because it looks cool on the internet doesn't mean it's a good idea for your kitchen. The second thing I'm going to share with you has to do with our shower. I just don't like seeing shampoo bottles when I walk into a beautiful bathroom. If you look in a magazine, you never see someone's razor or soap in there. You see beautiful shower, and that's where your focus goes. So what we did was we built a wall, short wall that's not there before, and we built a bench and we have the niche hidden. So we designed the shower, since we were designing the room, we made sure to tackle that little pet peeve. The third thing we did was address the lighting in our house. First of all, we took a ceiling fan that we've had forever. It was awful. I don't know why we waited this long to change it. We got a nice, simple, plain fan for our bedroom, and same with the other rooms. But while we had the electrician here, we had them add spotlights above our bed, reading lights, and electrical controls, so we can control the switches from the bed. You don't have to get up. Little pet peeve, but who wants to be laying in bed? You have to get out of bed, shut the light. Why not have the electrician fix that? So that's an easy fix. You don't have to be doing a home remodel. Just get an electrician in and you can fix that. We chose not to go with a smart feature for that and just use regular hard wiring electric, just because I sometimes personally don't like to always rely on a smartphone for things like that. Easy enough just to have a switch right next to you. This way, if your phone's not there, you don't have to rely on your smartphone for that feature. Thank you for watching Decisions with Dani. If you have any questions, you can always call me, 480-REALTOR, that's 480-732-5867.